You know, obviously I was pretty excited. I was definitely expecting the worst at that point, just because of what's happened in the past, and you know, probably a little bit embarrassing about how I overreacted now, I suppose. But you know, it was just one of those sensitive things where I kind of knew what has happened in the past, and I was kind of dreading that. So once I heard what the actual diagnosis was, and I should have been more composed going up to that point, but you know, it was a huge relief.
Rob, do you have a timeline as to when you might be back?
Not really. I'm just taking the docs and trainers' advice day by day, but you know, I feel good right now, so I feel like if things continue to progress, it shouldn't be long, hopefully next week.
How limited are you right now? How specifically does it feel?
Again, I've been really just following the doctor's orders, so they've been kind of just making sure I take it easy for the last few days. I haven't really been allowed to go out and do what I normally would do, but I feel like come this weekend, hopefully Saturday, I'll be able to get out there and do a little bit more and then just progress throughout the week.
What did you mind when you went down?
You know, there wasn't a lot of physical pain, just obviously kind of flashback for the last 2 years. So, you know, like I said, I wish I could handle myself a little bit better, but I just didn't want that to be the last time I played in front of these people in Saskatchewan, and just kind of overreacted, I guess.
When you were running patterns here before practice the other day, did you, obviously at the point you didn't know what the extent was, did any doctors give you advice about not doing that, or what was your thought process when you were running those patterns?
Yeah, I mean, I wasn't going full out in the patterns, and I was, again, I was following what Ivan had told me I couldn't do, so I was just kind of messing around. I just wanted to see, you know, what it felt like, regardless of what was about to be diagnosed in the afternoon, I suppose. I just kind of wanted to have it was my own personal opinion, I guess, and you know, felt good that day, and I expected to feel better this weekend.
And the coach, I think the term he used when they gave you the news was you were shocked. Is that accurate?
I was, yeah, I was, you know, pleasantly shocked. I think it was more a matter of me just, I didn't want to be disappointed if it wasn't what I expected, or if it was an ACL, I guess. So I think I was just preparing myself for the worst.
Were you taken back?
What does it mean to you? I mean, not just from your teammates after the game, but over Twitter the last couple of days for you.
I mean, it's been very humbling, it's been overwhelming, to be honest. I've always appreciated the fans and the support and all the friends I've had around the league, but it really was, you know, over the top how nice everyone was being. So hopefully they're all laughing at me now and taking their comments back, but it was, you know, it was very nice of everyone.
When you had a moment like that, though, now we know it's a good news story, but in the last few days before you get the diagnosis, was there a thought process about this could be a career ender? And were you thinking beyond your football career in those last few days?
You know, I wasn't really thinking beyond football, but I was definitely, you know, I'd be lying if I said I hadn't, you know, I didn't feel like that was probably not a good thing that had happened and that it could be the end. So thankfully I have a great wife at home and two kids that kept my mind off things until I found out what was actually going on.
Rob, it happened on a block. Are you concerned that the knee gave out on such an innocent play?
Yeah, I think that's probably always a concern, but like I said, I guess you know, it definitely tweaked. Like I said, I wouldn't necessarily say it gave out in retrospect. You know, to answer your question, yeah, I don't like the fact that it did something like that anytime, and a movement I've done thousands of times just this season alone. So, you know, that does bother me a little bit, but you know, Ivan's in there addressing it. You know, little tweaks and stuff like that happen to other guys, and their reaction wouldn't be as severe because they don't have the history that I have had, I think, and that's the reason why I think, I guess I was so dramatic about it.
Was it a relief to be able to go through like that and know that your ligaments did hold up?
I haven't thought about it that way, but I guess it should be, yeah. I mean, you know, we have a great surgeon out here that took care of me, and the work he's done is obviously obviously helped, and I feel like it's still strong, and I guess I'm just looking forward to moving past this as well.
Was a second opinion sought after the test came back? Is that why there was a bit of a delay in the announcement?
I talked to a few people, yeah, so I've got a few opinions, but collectively this is what they've told me. So I don't know what's done behind closed doors, obviously, but it pretty much, when I knew, it pretty much came out that day.